आप जानते हैं कि मुंबई शहर लावा के ऊपर बना हुआ है? ये लावा लाखों वर्ष पहले मौजूदा सेशेल्स द्वीप पर फटे ज्वालामुखी से निकला था। भूवैज्ञानिक उस घटना को डक्कन वोल्केनिज्म के नाम से जानते हैं। इस बारे में और ज्यादा जानने के लिए हमने तलछट भूवैज्ञानिक डॉक्टर सुव्रत खेर से बात की।
So, Deccan volcanism refers to a fairly prolonged period of volcanic eruptions that took place beginning around 68 million years ago and affecting generally the western part of India. And from that we know that India was around 30 degrees south of the equator when these eruptions started, around 120, 140 million years ago. What would eventually became India was part of a large supercontinent known as Gondwanaland. And for various reasons, Gondwanaland began to break up around 140 million years ago. So, and what became Antarctica and Australia, these two large blocks broke away. Around 100 million years ago, what became Africa broke away. And by that time, India, what became India, the large continental block that was left, started drifting northwards. So Indian plate, the tectonic plate, started moving northwards. Around 88 million years ago, another big piece broke off from the western part of that larger Indian continental landmass that became Madagascar. And around 68 million years ago, the Indian continental block moved over what is known as the Reunion Hotspot. Now, Reunion Hotspot, or the word hotspot, refers to an unusually hot area deep in the subsurface of the Earth, in the Earth's mantle. And what happens is when continents move over such hotspots, and especially in an environment where continents are breaking up, so they're fragmenting, they're stretching, that stretching of the continent results in the heat from the interior rising up as what is known as a plume. So as these plumes move up, they're buoyant because they're hot. As they move up, the pressure on them starts decreasing because, you know, the continents are being stretched apart. And so that is decompressing the mantle underneath. And when you decompress a very hot rock, it lowers the melting point of the rock and it triggers large scale melting of the mantle. So that is roughly what happened beginning around 68 million years ago, that India happened to sit on top of this Reunion hotspot. It was also stretching, the continent was stretching. That led to buoyant material rising up, melting, and then material then made its way through fractures and reached the surface and then erupted and spread over vast areas, forming the extent of the Deccan Traps or Deccan Volcanic Province as we know it. The word province simply denotes that it's a very, very large area that is covered by these volcanic rocks. So if you look at a geological map of India, you see that the volcanic province covers an incredibly large area. And generally the standard color to depict these volcanic rocks is green in most maps. In some maps it could be different. But what you'll find is that close to 80-85% of the surface of Maharashtra is covered by the Deccan basalts. Then some part of MP, Madhya Pradesh, is covered by basalts. Southern part of Gujarat is covered by basalts. And interestingly, what is not depicted in these geologic maps is that the Deccan basalts don't stop at the coastlines. They continue for tens of kilometers under the Arabian Sea. So the Arabian Sea seabed is actually made up of Deccan basalts for tens of kilometers westwards. And also eastwards in the Bay of Bengal, although disconnected from the main outcrop of Deccan volcanism, are volcanic rocks which are equivalent, that means erupted at the same time as Deccan and considered as part of the Deccan volcanism, at places near Rajmundry and then eastwards again into the seabed of the Bay of Bengal. So all in all, it's more than half a million square kilometers of lava province that erupted between 68 million years and around 63 million years ago. And although these eruptions occurred over such a long time, they were not continuous. They occurred in pulses. So there was a shorter, smaller pulse around 68, 67 million years ago. And then there were two enormous pulses around 66, 67 million years ago and 65 million years ago. And then the volcanic activity kind of petered out a little bit. It died out over most of the province, except interestingly around the city, what is now city of Mumbai. And so Mumbai has some of the youngest Deccan volcanic rocks of all, around 62 million year old. And people, you know, you must have seen pictures of Gilbert Hill, for example. It's a very famous natural monument in Mumbai near Andheri. That is very much part of the Deccan volcanic lava. And it has acquired this very peculiar structure known as columnar jointing. Because lava, when it comes to the surface, cools very rapidly. And it cools along certain points of shrinkage. And so that shrinkage causes polygonal cracks in the lava surface, leading to these joints. Other interesting places to visit in the Deccan basalts would be the Ajanta and Ellora caves. I know they occur at a particular level at an altitude in the hill ranges around near Aurangabad. But you know, these kind of Buddhist rock cut caves are found all over Maharashtra. And near Pune, there are two famous caves called Karla and Bhaje caves. Now, one interesting aspect of these caves is that they have been all been dug out from the same eruptive layer of Deccan lava known as the Bushi formation. So there must have been something about the rock properties of that layer that the excavators found easy to use a chisel and hammer and remove parts of the rock and also create lovely curved shapes. Now, some types of basalt are very hard to work with. You know, if you take a hammer to them and try to break it, they'll splinter into sharp edges. And those are not very workable material as far as artisans are concerned. But so the artisans at the time chose the lava layers very carefully. And so you see those wonderful sculptures in Ellora, Ajanta, Bhaje, Karle, all been dug out from the same layer of lava that exists right through Maharashtra.
दिलचस्प बात यह है कि दक्कन वॉल्केनिज्म को ही डायनासोर की उत्पत्ति का कारण माना जाता है। कुछ विद्वानों का यह भी मानना है कि डायनासोरों के विलुप्त होने का कारण एक विशाल क्षुद्र ग्रह या एस्टेरॉयड था जो मेक्सिको की खाड़ी में वर्तमान युकटेन के पास गिरा था। डॉक्टर खेर हमें कुछ इस तरह समझाते हैं।
The extinction of dinosaurs did occur in India about 3.5 lakh years, so 350,000 years before the meteorite impact. And you must be familiar that the main theory for the mass extinction that wiped out the dinosaurs is that a large meteor came and struck what is now the Yucatan Peninsula in Mexico. And that pretty much wiped out 70% of species on Earth, including the dinosaurs. But of late, there has been a lot of interest in trying to understand what impact did the Deccan volcanism have on life around that time. Because the Deccan volcanism overlaps the mass extinction. So there was some volcanism that occurred before the mass extinction and some that occurred after the mass extinction. So it overlaps the meteorite impact and it overlaps the mass extinction. So there's been an increasing interest in finding out that, such prolific volcanism must have had some environmental impact. And are there traces of that in the fossil record? Both the terrestrial fossil record and the marine, that is the sea fossil record. And so with that idea in mind, a lot of research has been done on the dinosaur fossils found in near Jabalpur, in Kheda, in Bhuj area, and led by Professor Dhananjay Mohabe and his colleagues. And they have found out by estimating the age of the sediments that it does look like volcanism, this Deccan volcanism wiped out dinosaurs a good 350,000 years before the meteorite impact. And so as far as India was concerned, at least, it does look like Deccan volcanism had a large role to play in the local extinction of dinosaurs. Now you can't say the same thing about the global extinction because there are sedimentary rocks which are younger than the level at which dinosaurs become extinct in India, which contain dinosaur fossils across the world. So in the United States, in Argentina. And so dinosaurs did continue to live globally elsewhere while the volcanism was going on. And so the meteorite impact also was a contributor to the extinction. I mentioned some rocks on the East Coast, and those are quite interesting. because they also are very valuable in telling us about how volcanism affected the environment. So east of Rajahmundry, under the Bay of Bengal seabed, ONGC is quite interested in the area because it's quite rich in oil. And so it periodically drills through the seabed of Bay of Bengal. And researchers have taken advantage of those recovered rocks from deep under the seabed. And they have found out a similar pattern of volcanism alternating with periods of sediment, which are now buried about 3 kilometers under the ocean. So, and in those sediments are marine creatures called foraminifera. So they're a group of unicellular protists. And they occur in large numbers and they fossilize easily. And so they are kind of preferred fossil by paleontologists to understand large scale changes and in environment. And so analysis of that does show that as Deccan eruptions proceeded around 67, 66 million years ago, the diversity of this foraminifera decreased. So there was a decrease in biodiversity, pointing to stresses in accumulating stresses in the environment. So you see less and less species of foraminifera in younger and younger sediment, which alternate with the big lava flows. And so the question that was framed say around 20 years ago, that it was the meteorite that was the main cause of this extinction. And it was always posed as an either or question, that was it the meteor that caused the extinction or was it Deccan volcanism? I think that question has now evolved into not an either or, but a question of a joint kind of a both of these events having an impact on the history of life on the Earth at that time. It may be difficult to tease out exactly how much of the extinction was caused by the meteorite impact and how much by Deccan volcanism. But a lot of work done on volcanism recently by both Indian geologists and international teams is increasing our awareness that this volcanism played a big role in the extinction. Even if it was not the main cause or the sole cause, it certainly contributed to loss of diversity. And since the volcanism continued even after the meteorite impact for quite a long period of time, it halted or it slowed down the recovery of ecosystems. And people who are interested in understanding broad patterns of life, now how does certain groups of organisms persist for a long period of time? How do they diversify? What happens when most of them die out? How long does it take for the survivors to proliferate and diversify again? Now these are the questions that are being addressed by sediments which are trapped in between the lava flows and by sediments which were deposited at the same time as the lava flows all over the world. And that makes studying Deccan volcanism extremely valuable in understanding this history of life as it occurred in the time spanning around 68, 69 million years ago and going into around 62, 63 million years ago. And obviously, because the volcanism created these enormous lava layers spread out over enormous parts of the country, it has formed a very unique physiographic province that is not found anywhere else in India. So we have large parts of the area covered under lava, and over time, over millions of years, a combination of earth movements and erosion has dissected this lava plateau into the spectacular Western Ghats, into a series of ridges and pinnacles and mesas and cliffs. Understanding Deccan basalts is of broad value to geologists. It tells us about plate tectonics. It tells us about the journey of India from much south of the equator to where we lie today by the northward movement of plates, by understanding the magnetic signatures preserved in these rocks. It tells us about biological diversity, how it crashed in the latter parts of this volcanic eruptive phase and how it recovered, or what are the patterns of recovery by using the sediment. And it has given us this fantastic landscapes to admire and enjoy and reflect on what happened 66 million years ago, give and take 1 or 2 million years in here and there, shaping the geological evolution of this country.
इन दक्कन ट्रैप्स में पृथ्वी के कई रहस्य और उन रहस्यों के जवाब छिपे हुए हैं। लेकिन दुर्भाग्य से देश की अन्य भू विरासत की तरह ये भी अनदेखी और उलझुल विकास का शिकार है।
I had the privilege of being invited to attend the inauguration of one of the metro tunnels in Mumbai. So we were taken about 40-50 feet underground and then through a tunnel towards from Wadala towards little westward for about half a kilometer. And the geologist was there was telling me that in Mumbai too, there are sediments which occur in between the lava flows. You know, just like the sites are described in the north of Maharashtra, Mumbai at the time of the Deccan eruptions or in the last phases of the Deccan eruptions was actually at sea level. And so between periods of quiescence, so there was a lava flow, then nothing much happens. And so in the lakes and ponds and estuaries that formed there, life again proliferated. And you have frog fossils, plant remains, fish, all trapped in those sediments in between those lava flows. And sadly enough, you know, the rate at which Mumbai is growing and the rate at which rock faces are being erased, we are losing that heritage. And there are very, very few places now in Mumbai where you can actually see a natural rock face with those intertrapian sediments containing fossils. And so there's another, I think, aspect that Mumbai authorities should look at seriously and at least try to preserve some sites. I understand that not all can be preserved, you know, but at least some sites should be selected and protected and preserved. So people will get an idea of the really unique history of geological history of Mumbai. The rocks are a little different from the main Deccan traps. Just having those intertrapian sediments, which are kind of unusual, and they occur not in the central part of the Deccan volcanic province, but on the margins. And Mumbai is lucky to have those kind of sediments. So it would be really worthwhile to protect some of these sites for people to appreciate and bring them a little closer to nature and our natural history.